Hello students, today we will study the adsorption isotherms. There are two isotherms which are based upon adsorption. They were given by the two scientists. The first one was the Freundlich and the second one is Langmuir. Today we will study about the Freundlich adsorption isotherm. Okay, to describe the relationship between the amount of the gas adsorbed and mass of the adsorbent x by m and p. It is isotherm, means at constant temperature. So he suggested the following equation, and the equation according to him was x by m, it is equals to k p raised to the power 1 by n. Okay, so this was the equation which was given by Freundlich to explain the adsorption process. And there was a graph between x by m and pressure. See, we can easily see that at lower pressure the graph is a straight line, but it is showing a slight curve here at higher pressure. Okay, that's why this was not universally accepted. This was a demerit of this adsorption isotherm. So first we'll study about this equation, which is x by m is equals to k p raised to the power 1 by n. According to him, k and n, these two are constants, and the values of these two are dependent upon the nature of adsorbent and temperature. Okay, this thing we have to keep in mind, because this was his demerit. As these two are dependent upon the temperature, how they can be a constant? Yes. And if we'll take log of the equation 1, this equation 1, we'll get log base 10 x by m, it is equals to this 1 by n log base 10 p plus log base 10 k. So when the graph was drawn between log base 10 x by m and log base 10 p, the slope was coming out to be equal to 1 by n. Okay, and this log base 10 k, it was the intercept here. So these are the two graphs which were drawn by the Freundlich according to the process of adsorption when the temperature is constant. Okay, now we'll study about the limitations of this Freundlich adsorption isotherm. See, the limitation is, first limitation is, this equation is purely empirical. There is no theoretical proof behind this equation. The second one is the same. The straight lines are only at low pressure. At low pressure, they are the straight line. And at higher pressure, there is a slight curvature. Now, K and N, they are not constant in true sense, because they are dependent upon the temperatures. And he was unable to explain the kinetics of the adsorption, whether the reaction is of first order, second order, third order, zero order, or fractional order. Okay. Now, adsorption from solution. Yes, we have studied that there was a solid in which gases were adsorbed earlier here. But not only gases, but solids were also getting adsorbed from the solution. Only solids were getting adsorbed by the solid. Like examples are here, raw sugar. Actually, when the aqueous solution of raw sugar, it was passed through animal charcoal, the colored material which was present in the raw sugar, it was getting adsorbed on the surface of charcoal. It means liquid, the colored component of the liquid, it was getting adsorbed on the charcoal. Okay. Second one is, when the aqueous solution of acetic acid in water, this solution, it was shaken with charcoal, the concentration of this acetic acid, it was decreasing in the solution. It means acetic acid was getting adsorbed on the surface of charcoal. Yes. And similarly, when the charcoal, it was added to litmus solution, the color of the litmus solution, it was it started fading, or it was becoming colorless. It means that the colored component from the litmus, they were getting adsorbed on charcoal. So here, see, adsorption from solutions is here. Here the concentration was changing. x by m, it is equals to k instead of pressure. Concentration term is here c 1 by n, where x is the mass of the solute adsorbed, m is the mass of the solid adsorbed, and c is the equilibrium concentration of the solute in the solution. Okay, k is a constant here, and the equation x by m is equals to k c raised to the power 1 by n. It can also be written as log base 10 x by m, it is equals to log base 10 k plus 1 upon n log base 10 c. This reaction, it is of type y is equals to mx plus c type reactions there, and it will also represent a straight line when the graph was placed between this log base 10 x by m and log base 10 c. Here too 1 by n will be a slope and log base 10 k will be a intercept. Now tomorrow we will study about the Langmuir adsorption isotherm, where we will study about the kinetic study of the adsorption process. Thank you.